Reports of near simultaneous strikes on Iran targets in Isfahan, home to the nuclear facilities, as well as targeting air bases in Daraa and Suwaida in northern Syria, home to the radar and air defense sites. Developing. If they're targeting air defense sites and radar, and it's not a one-off, or maybe it is, I don't know, but it doesn't feel like it would be a one-off. Intel Doge says two flights over Iran bound for Dubai turning around. I mean, that's just two flights. They both turned around right before getting near Isfahan. I mean, they're probably turning around, I assume, because they saw the explosion and they're worried. The Suwaida 24 correspondent, preliminary information indicates that unidentified warplanes carried out airstrikes on Syrian military sites between the governorates. More details, they come in. Strong sounds of warplanes flying in the southern countryside preceded in minutes by the sounds of three successive explosions, the sound of which was heard in the city of Suwaida and the western countryside. J-Post is only confirming explosions in Syria. I thought they also... No, explosions heard in Iran, Syria, and Iraq. Syrian reports indicated airstrikes targeted sites belonging to the Syrian army in Suwaida and Daraa governorates of southern Syria. Explosions were heard in Isfahan in central Iran, in the Suwaida governorate of southern Syria, and in the Baghdad area and the Babel governorate of Iraq early Friday morning. There was no official confirmation of explosions in Iraq and Iran or of their cause as of early Friday morning. From the Al-Mayadeen correspondent in Baghdad, an explosion was heard, the cause of which was unknown, in the Imam district of Babel governorate south of the country. If it's explosions in Syria and Iraq, it's Iranian proxies. If it's actually explosions inside of Iran, then it's also Iran directly. Israeli attacks confirmed, breaking Israeli missiles. Oh, shit. Pentagon reporter and producer for ABC. Okay, now Israel is confirming that they did hit Iran. A senior U.S. official tells our Martha Raddatz. That is real confirmation. That's very different than OSINT shit. All right, let's tune into CNN, see what they're talking about. Oh, my God, bro.
Can see that. And remember, the only discretion CNN. That we got from the judge was use common
CNN,
sense.
CNN, do your job.
So people's
CNN.
Versions of common sense are very different when it comes to what you do in terms of the media. So you should expect
this
these right-wing
is not unverified.
Media, you know, followers to be pushing this forward.
Who cares?
So, to that point.
What do you mean, who cares? Bro, what are we talking about? Do people not understand what's happening? Israel has in the past covertly targeted Iranian nuclear capabilities. How do I describe it? It's one of those things where it's never acknowledged fully. It's never really acknowledged. Sometimes the Israeli government acknowledges it as a flex, but oftentimes it is not. It's like an open secret, specifically this facility. That is the difference, however, is that It's never been done in a way where there was like active heat and international eyes on the matter. So I don't know. It is odd, however, the way that this was done, because I feel like normally in a situation, as Elint News also pointed out, under normal circumstances, there's more local media coverage instantaneously. And then beyond that, there's like air raid sirens, just like other markers that an all-out air attack is happening in all of the places. But the only solid confirmation we have so far is this. This has like 200 views because it just happened. Oh, here it is. Israeli missiles have hit a site in Iran. A U.S. official confirmed to ABC News Israeli missiles have hit a site in Iran. The official could not confirm whether the Syria and Iraq sites were hit as well. This is weird. This is very weird. Like, why is it only on ABC News like this?
We turn now to ABC's Matt Gutman, who is in Israel with the latest reporting. Matt, what are you hearing?
Juju, a senior U.S. official telling us that Israeli missiles have hit at least one site inside Iran. No reports yet on casualties or what specifically this site was. As you mentioned, Israel has been telegraphing that it will respond. Officials telling me at the time and place of their choosing, they did not specify what that response would be like. We didn't know when it would come. And of course, this is in response to that massive missile salvo from last Saturday, the largest ballistic missile salvo in history. And of course, Iran has said that if Israel chooses to respond, their Iranian response would be severe and immediate. Juju.
Matt, thank you. From the latest in Israel, let's turn now to Chief Global Affairs anchor Martha Raddatz in D.C. with the latest. Martha, what are you hearing?
It is a single senior U.S. official who said that it had started, that Israel had retaliated and hit one site in Iran. There are reports this evening that other places, Iraq and Syria, have been hit. This U.S. senior official said they simply cannot confirm that. There were reports yesterday that Israel would hold off on these strikes until after Passover. But today we started getting indications that it could come much quicker than that. The senior official also said the Israelis have been quite secretive about this, so there's very little information we have at this point about the strike that the U.S. senior official said that Israel had made inside Iran.
Well, Martha Raddatz, thank you for that update. Of course, we will return to our regular reporting. This has been a special report. Stay tuned, of course, for the latest updates.
That's it.
And we return you now to your regular programming.
This has been a special report from ABC News.
Our thanks to Juju for that. Good evening. I'm Lindsay Davis. For those of you who are just joining us, we are, of course, following breaking news. Israel has retaliated against Iran, and we are learning from a senior U.S. official. Israeli missiles have hit a site in Iran. There have been explosions heard in Iraq and Syria. At this hour, it is not clear the cause of those explosions. All of this comes just days after Iran fired hundreds of ballistic missiles into Israel. 99% of those were intercepted. Israel's war cabinet has spent the better part of the week debating a response. There was some talk of waiting until after the Jewish holiday of Passover. We're waiting for a U.S. response at this point, but President Biden had told Netanyahu that Israel would have to go at it alone on any counterstrike against Iran. I want to pivot now and bring in Mick Mulroy, also an ABC News contributor and former Deputy Assistant Secretary of Defense for the Middle East. Mick, how big of an escalation is this for the region?
So if it is true that these strikes were in Iran, then it could be an escalation, but we have to see what targets were hit. If they were nuclear sites, that would be a very substantial escalation. If it was a site, say, that was a manufacturer of the Shahed drones that attacked Iran, potentially not as escalatory. But really, it does come down to the perception of Iran. Right now, it's really important for us to find out what happened, and I'm sure that's exactly what the U.S. government is doing to try to gather this information and be prepared potentially for a counterattack, which could have been already prepared by Iran knowing this was likely coming.
How concerned are you about the potential for a full-scale regional conflict?
I think everybody should be concerned about a full-scale regional conflict right now. This was substantial, the attack by Iran on Israel. That's why they felt like they had to respond. But the biggest concern, I think, with all countries involved, including countries in the region, was this could escalate. And it could escalate to a point where it's just nonstop. There is no calculated return. It is just an exchange of fire from Iran to Israel, Israel to Iran, which, of course, would be devastating to the region.
For our viewers at home, how concerned, people are thinking, oh, this is half a world away, but what could the impacts be here in the United States and beyond?
So yes, it is half a world away, but the world itself is much closer than it's ever been, especially when it comes to the economy. And I'm not an economic analyst, but you don't have to be to realize just how big of an impact this could have on world oil prices, for example, which is the underlying cost of everything that's transferred around the world. So this could be very substantial for the world community, and that's why there's so much attention to this right now.
All right, Mick Mulroy, our thanks to you. Want to bring in Matt Gutman, who is on the ground for us.
Bro, Isfahan, like, limited or not, nuclear facility or not, is still a target on Iranian soil.
You understand that Israel, according to at least one U.S. official, has fired missiles that have landed in Iran. We don't know the nature of the site, what they targeted. We don't know if there are casualties at this point. There may be additional strikes in other places. We don't have that yet confirmed. Of course, this is in retaliation to that massive
missile. Yeah, they're talking about oil prices in the same way that I talk about oil prices. They have to talk about it because that is how wars are fought and won, okay? They're talking about the impact that this will potentially have for the United States of America because they're American news broadcasters and they don't give a shit about Iranian lives or the lives of anybody else for that matter. That's why they're covering it from that perspective, as I have as well, time and time again. because Iran retaliating. Iranian Fars Agency says explosions sounded near Isfahan Airport and Hashtam Shikari Air Base. Yeah, I just don't think that Matt Saylor replied to you. What did he say? He said, we're working to confirm whether those reported explosions from Israeli strikes. I can't understand how there isn't more information on this in real time. It might not be the nuclear, it might not be the nuclear facility, which is fine, but it still means it is a escalation, as in it is a direct attack to Iranian soil attacks. From Israel. Now, Israel has struck Iranian soil in the past, but it's more of like a open secret type situation, like I said, not necessarily with this many eyeballs. Especially with like the Iranian government saying that they will have a severe and swift retaliation if such a strike would occur.
Attack from its territory to Iranian territory and been essentially public about it, Lindsay.
And of course, many people are concerned about the implications of that on a wider scale. Matt Gutman, our thanks to your reporting in from
the fact that the Iranian government is saying like, oh, we don't know the source of the attack is actually very interesting, specifically because I feel like if they acknowledge it, then it demands swift retaliation.
Ongoing since October 7th between Hezbollah and Israel, it's safe to say. So that is the main issue here for Hezbollah. Does it get actively involved in a war with Israel? I mean, look, this is Iran's largest and most powerful proxy. They have some more than 100,000 rockets, according to the CIA. And actually, more Hezbollah fighters have been killed since October 7th than were killed in the war between Israel and Hezbollah in 2006. So it's safe to say the war here has already begun. But every time Nasrallah, the leader of Hezbollah here in Lebanon, has been asked about Hezbollah's role in this war, he always talks about needing to have solidarity with the people of Gaza, wanting to support Hamas, supporting the October 7th attacks, but crucially not wanting to get more involved in this war. It just might not be up to him if Israel chooses to respond to these attacks by Iran by hitting Iran's largest proxy in this country. Tonight it's too early to say exactly what targets have been hit by the Iranians, but it doesn't seem at this point.
The cause of the sounds is still unknown. Investigations continue until the exact details of the incident are determined, a semi-official Fars news agency said. Iran's Fars news agency said on Friday the explosions were heard near the airport of the country's central Isfahan city, but the reasons was unknown. It is interesting to see that the Iranian government is not hitting the full tilt, like this was Israel and we're retaliating. We also have no further confirmation on the reasons or the strikes or the targets on the potential explosions being heard in Syria and Iraq. We don't know anything. There might literally not even have been any explosions, and we just, I guess, saw it on Twitter. It sucks. The footage seemed legit to you? No, man. No footage seems legit. And people that say this footage was posted by the IRGC, they're not actually getting the footage from the IRGC, okay? They're going to Telegram. They're simply going to Telegram, and they're posting shit that they find on Telegram. This is more official. NOTAM has popped up for Tehran airspace, and 17 minutes ago, it was for the Isfahan airspace. Telegram is accurate. No, brother. You have no idea what you're looking at half the time. You might be looking at explosions from 2003. You might be looking at ARMA footage, okay?
Flight tracking that a number of flights have diverted their flights over the skies and away from the skies of Iran this evening. We also understand that a NOTAM, a no-fly zone, has been declared in the west of Iran.
I was just about to explain to you what a NOTAM was, and he did. So there you go, Chatter. You got your information.
From local sources on the ground, locally reported, unconfirmed by us, that there have been other explosions. We can also say that earlier on this evening, a number of small earthquakes were detected in Iran. all of these different developments, John, we're trying to piece together to give a complete picture of what is happening. Of course, there has been huge expectation that Israel was going to strike back in a decisive way at Iran. Indeed, Prime Minister Netanyahu said just a couple of days ago that that would be happening, and the British Foreign Secretary indicated he understood there would be strikes in Iran. What we are trying to assess right now is who is behind these explosions reported in Isfahan, what the bigger picture is adding up to at the moment, and therefore the implications that this might lead to. I think we're at the very leading edge here, John, of trying to get a solid picture of what is happening in Iran tonight. But airspace affected, explosions reported around a significant city with significant bases and a major nuclear research facility in Iran tonight, John.
And Nick, a second Iranian media outlet now reporting that in Isfahan that there have been significant strikes there. So let's stay with it. You mentioned we've been expecting this. Just for our viewers, I'll just go through the timeline. Remember, back on April 1st, Israel was blamed for an attack on the Iranian consulate in Damascus, Syria. And then, as Nick noted, back last Saturday on the 13th, Iran deployed more than 300 drones and other aerial weapons to attack on Israel. After that, Nick, the president of the United States, who helped the United States, Britain, other Western allies, helped repel the Iranian attack. And the appeal from President Biden to Israel was, you prove they couldn't hit you. You know, don't do anything provocative. Don't do anything that further escalates a region already on end. Prime Minister Netanyahu has not listened to the president of the United States.
My man said blame, by the way.
Conflict.
Is it safe blame to say for the strike on the embassy compound.
John, I think what it's safe to say at the moment is that it appears as in all likelihood that Israel has struck Iran. Now, if this has happened, has the Prime Minister dialed back what he might have otherwise planned? Certainly, there's been a huge international...
Bro, don't even know the details and he's already running cover. That's crazy, bro. Get the dick out of your mouth. Holy shit. That's crazy.
The president of Israel, do not escalate the situation, but both seem to accept that Israel was going to go ahead, John.
Bro, that's insane to be like, yeah, I mean, we don't even know what happened, but it's probably, you know, Israel's probably being restrained here. They can't say now getting an update that a second on the news like that anymore. Those days ended on 9/11. That's insane, bro. That's insane to...
Good evening. I'm Abby Phillip in New York. There's breaking news tonight. Reports that Israel may have hit back. Iran's semi-official Fars news agency, citing local sources, says tonight an explosion was heard northwest of Isfahan.
This comes from now multiple Iranian semi-official news outlets. The latest from Press TV reporting that an explosion was heard near Iran's central city of Isfahan. The reason is still unknown, and that echoes what we heard just moments ago from another semi-official news agency called Fars.
Is it Hezbollah airstrike 7 hours ago?
So here we have Iranian media reporting an explosion or explosions in one of Iran's most prominent cities, Isfahan. It is in the middle of the country, towards the western part of the country. It does have a prominent nuclear facility, but I will note that this was near Isfahan. So it is very much unclear what the target may have been, indeed how this was carried out. We have not heard anything, Abby, from the IDF, from any Israeli officials. We have not heard anything from any American officials. We, of course, are checking with our sources. This is something that we have been anticipating for several days now. It has always been a...
Twitter has literally gotten worse. It's just gotten so much worse. There's no breaking real-time news reporting happening
this historic attack
on this godforsaken platform
without escalating the situation.
Don't click that shit, bro. It doesn't matter. It's good to sometimes click the specifically to dial back. Twitter is the best. You don't follow OSIN accounts, you need to do that, sir. There's a reason why I don't follow OSIN accounts. This is the reason. Bro, shut up about Blue Sky, okay? If I want to learn about how, like, eating Kellogg's Frosted Flakes is ableist, then I'll go to Blue Sky, okay? The next time I want to hear about how, like, I don't know, queer theory needs to also factor in, like, I don't know, Aboriginal tribes or something, I'll go to Blue Sky, okay? Like, that's the most prescient, most important thing that I need to worry about. Update direct from Iranian media. New flights to Tehran, Isfahan, Shiraz, and all of the other airports in Western Iran have been suspended. Iran state-affiliated Mehr news agency reports. Okay, this is more substantive. It's just like, if I want to read radical disabled queer praxis or something, like a poster saying shit like that, I'll go to Blue Sky, okay?
Lights in the skies above Iran have indicated within the past hour or so that flights have been changing their flight paths to avoid Iranian airspace. We're also aware that in the last half an hour or so, a NOTAM, a no-fly declaration has been
made. I didn't
know
you had this much smoke for Blue Sky. It's just like, it's fun to look at from the outside, but it's not something that I can utilize for real-time coverage. Because it's mostly that I talk about, like most that I meme about. That's what it is. And no, you can't get captions because they're broken.
Covert route for them might be from the West. So that piece of information, I think, is telling and important. And I think what first caught our attention here earlier on this evening, which could be completely unrelated, but a number of small earthquakes were recorded in several Iranian desert locations outside of cities. Now there's no
bro, they got the earthquake gun on God, bro. That's it. I'm convinced, bro. Israel had the earthquake gun this whole time, dude. Why'd they do that to Taiwan?
In other cities, we know.
I'm kidding. Please don't take that seriously.
Other cities where the local population that we cannot confirm at the moment, I should stress that, cannot confirm, have reported unexplained explosions. Now, of course, in Iran, people can be concerned about the possibility of this pending Israeli airstrike threat, and people can misread things that can be as much as an exploding tire on the road outside of where they live. So I stress all this information has to be tracked down. And of course, Iran controls the information flow inside the country, and the internet is not ready available, and Twitter is not ready available, and high-speed cellular network connection is not so ready for people. The Iranian government controls that because they want to control the message and information, whether it's about protests on the street or the explosions that may be happening in the country. So the fact that we're only through the news channels that are sanctioned by the government of Iran hearing about explosions in one city or close to one city, Isfahan, is only as far as we can tell at the moment, part of the picture of what we think may be happening. But it's going to take time for us to look at what we're here, look at the details we're getting, cross-reference them, and try to get some better clarity on them.
Yeah, and Nick, as you're talking there, I just want to reset for people who may be just joining us. We can report now that there have been explosions heard inside of Iran near the city of Isfahan. That's about a few hundred miles south of Tehran. That's a city that is the third most populous city in Iran.
Iran is hiding. This means a lot. They're preparing a military response, in my opinion. No, they could be just trying to, they could be also hiding it like they have in the past when Israel has like conducted military operations on Iranian soil without openly stating it. But it doesn't all, if you noticed, a lot of the Iranian information that's coming out, a lot of the Iranian information that's coming out from Iranian sources simply confirm explosions and never really says like it's an Israeli strike. The only thing that we have to tie this back to Israel potentially, and even the ABC journalist who broke the story responded to me saying we haven't tied this back to Israel yet, was the ABC reporting coming from one U.S. official. One U.S. official stating that Israel has struck Iran. That's it. And also, I guess Marco Rubio stating that like Israel doesn't need to go into Iranian airspace to strike Iran. They have targeting and they have weapons that they can hit Iran with from Syrian and Iraqi airspace or something like that. But it is weird that there isn't more information on the matter. Isfahan is home to the Khatami airbase and is located northeast of the city. Yeah, he's just like tweeting this like, why is he vague posting? Bro, stop vague posting like a angsty teenager. What is happening? It's very odd. Like, what's going on? Oh, I really can't be alone right now, said Marco Rubio. Ladies, are you up? I really can't be alone right now. I'm feeling some type of way. I'm in my feelings. Yo, I never believed in magic until I saw all my dogs turn to snakes. Okay, what do you mean? Explain what you are saying. Israel has the ability to conduct airstrikes against targets inside Iran without entering the Iranian airspace from aircraft over Syrian and Iraqi airspace. Okay, what does that mean? Is that what's going on? Is that what's going on? You just say it. What is this vague posting? And then he's like, Isfahan is home to Qatami airspace. Yeah, he just thought this is a convenient time to drop facts that he knows about Iran, maybe. Breaking, semi-official Iranian Fars News, citing local sources, reports an explosion was heard northwest of Isfahan. Yeah, he's drake and driving currently. The Israeli Air Force attacked Iran for the first time in response to the Iranian attack on Saturday. This is how reports are flying in Iran and the United States. Alertness in Israel for the Iranian response. We are on a special broadcast on News 13. I mean, they don't know shit either. The thing is, they don't know either. Nobody knows what's going on. Literally no one knows. Not a single official, with the exception of the ABC report, has said a single damn thing.
So this is, a pretty serious turning point. I had commented earlier that, it looks like the Iranians crossed the Rubicon by attacking or attempting to attack Israel proper. Well, the other side of that Rubicon appears now has been crossed by Israel. So, where do we go from here?
Where do we go from here? The question That's of crazy. The hour. It just so happens that the CNN interviewed the Iranian foreign minister just 2 hours ago, live on this air. I want you to listen to what he told Aaron Burnett.
Our response to the Israeli regime was limited and stayed within a minimum of frameworks. We will not continue. However, in case the Israeli regime embarks on adventurism again and takes action against the interests of Iran, the next response from us will be immediate and at a maximum level. It will be decisive.
As a trained intelligence official, when you hear that pretty absolutist language, it will be immediate and at a maximum level. God. It will be decisive. What do you hear?
Well, I take him at his word. I think, right now the Iranian regime is very hard line, more so than perhaps in Iran's history. And so I take him at his word. I think they will.
MAP is a direct transposition of the NOTAM. The question is, the Notice the Airmen.
How can this be?
And it's the entire Iraq-Iran border.
If it can be at all, but I take seriously what he's saying, and I believe the Iranians will respond. And I don't believe they can't stand another embarrassment like the first attack where. They mounted this massive attack.
Isn't this guy being put in prison for treason already? Who, me?
Director Clapper, please stand by for us. I want to go live now to the Pentagon, where Oren Lieberman is there standing by. Oren, anything you're hearing right now from military officials in this country?
Not at this point. Right now, U.S. officials are being very quiet.
This is crazy.
We haven't gotten confirmation.
Not crazy. Not as crazy as forgetting to run the top of the hour ad break. And then running it 17 minutes in, but still crazy nonetheless. Here's a three-minute break right now. I'm going to go pee.
Minister Yoav Gallant. So it's difficult to see the situation we're playing out right now with reports of explosions in Isfahan, Iran, as well as some explosions in Syria and Iraq as anything other than the Israeli response that they had been promising. A few interesting points to make here. Over the course of the past 6 months, we have seen Israel openly talk about some of its strikes in Lebanon, a smaller number in Syria. Here it seems, if this is indeed Israel once again choosing to be quiet. And this is a policy they had followed for many, many years, not talking about actions and strikes that they would carry out in Syria, sometimes in Iraq. There were a number of reasons for that. One of those was simply not to be seen as boasting or bragging about an attack, not to add insult to injury. So potentially Israel once again following that policy right now, aware of not only how sensitive the entire situation in the region is, but also the desire of the United States not to see the situation escalate any more here. Now the question of explosions in Syria and Iraq. If Israel were to have attacked Iran, how would they do so, knowing that some of the countries that aided in the defense from the Iranian attack several days ago did not want to see anything coming through their airspace once again? Jordan, for example, would be an example of that. So how would Israel, if it wanted to, seek out to strike Iran? Obviously, the obvious choice there is going through Syria and then over Iraq directly into Iran, likely with some sort of long-range missile taken from a fighter jet. Now the question of where does this go from here? I'll go back to Aaron Burnett's interview with the Iranian foreign minister, which aired, as you pointed out, just a couple of hours ago. Despite the fact that that was a completely ineffective Iranian attack on Israel, the foreign minister claimed victory. So it'll be interesting to see how they describe this attack when they're able to say more. Do they simply call it a complete failure? And what does that mean for their response? That's something the U.S. and, in all likelihood, Israel are right now watching very closely. Abby, one more question. The countries that participated in the defense of the Iranian attack, given the fact that this was, or at least appears to be, the Israeli response, do they do so again, given what we're looking at here? And that's another question that the U.S. and others have to answer.
A lot of questions at this hour, Oren. Thank you.
My language is incredibly careful here because we don't know what's actually happening in the skies there. We don't know what aircraft are there. There's a broad supposition that this could be an Israeli strike, but we don't have confirmation of that. We know Israel's been talking about striking back, but we don't know what's happening. We can piece together the picture. Something untoward is happening in the skies above Iran, and there are explosions close to a city that has a principal nuclear research facility, as well as multiple military bases. Again, we don't know the precise locations of these explosions, but we do know that they appear to be ongoing in pattern, at least as recently as the last half an hour. We also know that we've been tracking some other reports that have not yet come on Iranian state media. These have been social media reports. They have not yet come on state media in Iran, in a couple of other cities. So let's be cautious about that information for the moment as we try to piece together at least what we know the state media is reporting in Iran.
That caution is important. I'm glad that you reiterated it. We've been telling our audience all hour so far that this is just really preliminary information, but these images, as you said, certainly seem to indicate that something is happening in Iran tonight. Nick, do stand by for us. We are getting word right now from Iran that flights into Tehran and Isfahan have been suspended. CNN military analyst and retired Major General Spider Marks is here with us as well. General Marks, what do these images tell you? I see it almost looks as if dawn is on the edge of breaking there, but I'm seeing in my multiple flashes of bright light in the sky. What do you see?
You guys thought I was joking when I said there's like...
Well, first of all, you know, what we have to keep in mind is, as Nick described, is there is a litany of assumptions that everybody is making right now, and we're trying to piece all this together. One assumption is, was the United States apprised before Israel, if Israel made a strike? Another assumption, was the United States apprised a priori? If there was a strike, was it a series of cruise missiles that were launched from Israel or launched from a fighter en route Iran that never hit Iran airspace, but in fact released those cruise missiles? What was the ordnance on those cruise missiles? Damage assessment on the ground? Were there multiple engagements? Was this...
Woman on NBC just said it's not a hyperbole to be concerned about a possible global conflict. Can't believe people got mad at you for that. Yes, because people are stupid, and they literally are only they only care about one thing, and that's just like on. They don't think.
The mother of all bombs.
They just react. They're reactionary.
Released a number of years ago in Afghanistan. Those have a very, because they're so large, about 30,000 pounds.
Notice language.
Can they be released by
an American official told Al Jazeera, we're aware of reports about Israel launching a strike inside?
Possibly an F-15 that was equipped appropriately. The empty wave of an F-15 plus the loaded weight underneath, you'd be right at the hair. in terms of the distance, the tolerance, and the ability to do that. But again, I mean, these are all assumptions that we're making that will be pieced together here shortly.
Very shortly, we hope, because certainly there's a lot of speculation going on right now about what might have happened here. I do want to go back to Alex Marquardt. Alex, you have some new reporting. What are you learning?
Well, just to answer the general's question there, Abby, there was a sense among U.S. officials that if there were a counterattack by Israel against Iran, that the U.S. would be warned about it, not just as a courtesy, because the U.S. is Israel's closest ally and its biggest supporter in terms of military aid and certainly in this war in Gaza, but also because an Iranian retaliation could significantly put American troops in harm's way. Of course, there are American troops in Syria, as well as Iraq. There are American ships throughout the Middle East. And so there was a sense from senior officials who I've been speaking with for the past few days that if Israel decided to carry something out, that they...
Told you. And also, America needs to prep up defenses, too, against Iranian retaliation.
Of what the U.S. knew and when. So, again, to underscore that we do not know right now whether Israel has carried out any kind of strike. But I want to emphasize something that I learned a couple days ago, Abby, and that is the U.S. expectation. They had been told by Israeli officials that were there to be a counterattack, and that was the expectation. We have been expecting something from Israel over the course of the past few days. That it would be, to quote one official, limited in scope. And what that would mean is essentially, we think, a handful of strikes. Another official was saying a kinetic attack against, say, military targets. Again, back to Israel's efforts to try to thread the needle in terms of sending a message to Iran, hitting back at Iran without escalating this situation. I was just speaking with a senior U.S. official just moments ago.
That's insane. That is not escalating the situation. Are you serious? That definitely is escalating
nuclear
the situation.
Nuclear facilities. So we're talking about Isfahan. We're talking about the nuclear facility that is there. And I'm being told now by a U.S. official that their understanding from Israeli officials was that they would not go after any nuclear facilities in a counterattack. Again, we do not know that the explosions happened near there or at that facility, and we again don't know whether Israel carried out any kind of attack. But that certainly was the understanding from U.S. officials. One
Taylor
more thing,
is
Abby,
releasing in a bit. Is that will we switch or
the
not?
U.S. thought that Israel was going Taylor? To do something and strike back at Iran because of that attack
what?
Last weekend. But the U.S. firmly did not want Israel to do this. And in speaking with this senior official just moments ago, that person said, there was no green light from the U.S. for any kind of retaliatory attack against Iran. Now, the U.S. is not.
If Taylor Swift drops an album instead of condemning the Zionist apartheid regime, I'm going to lose it. OK, she's fake.
Israel's war in Gaza. The U.S. certainly has a large amount of leverage. And the U.S., along with close allies,
so
France
unrelated,
and
but...
Britain, who, mind you, helped
helped
defend Israel last weekend. Other members of the G7, they all wanted Israel to, in the words of the White House, take the win, recognize that they had been attacked by Iran on a massive scale and done a very, very good job at defending themselves, knocking some 99% of the projected.
She announced this album months ago. Like, yeah, exactly. It's really f***ed up that Israel would ruin her album release by doing this. Am I right? Come on, Swifties. You must be with me. Think about it. She literally announced months ago that she was going to drop this album release, and now Israel chooses to strike. They couldn't wait like 3 days so that we could listen to it as Swifties, because I am one. We couldn't listen to it for like 3 whole days, and then maybe we could go back to World War III. It's kind of fucked up. Swifties, I'm with you. Just remember that I'm with you. Remember the Swiftie that actually refused to serve for the Israeli occupying force and had to go to prison. Remember that? She was also a Swiftie. I am a Swiftie. I'm with her. So think about that.
Others have said in these past few moments, the foreign minister of Iran saying very clearly right here on CNN that they are very willing to hit back hard, hit back quickly, and expand the kind of targets that they tried to go after last weekend, which, as far as we know, were just military. Abby?
Alex, as you're talking there, we're just getting some new information. Iran is now saying that its air defense systems have been activated, seemingly indicating there was some kind of attack that transpired in its airspace. As we're talking now, I want to bring in political global affairs analyst Barak Ravid. Barak, I know that you are working your sources inside of Israel, inside of the U.S. government, to find out as much as you can about what's going on here tonight. What are you hearing?
I don't hear much from the Israelis. One of Netanyahu's aides,
what happened, Barak?
Whom I spoke to just minutes ago.
I thought you had inside sources, Barak. What happened?
No comment. But on the other hand, you know, it's 5 a.m. now in Israel, and he was awake. So I think it tells you a lot, even if he says no comment. Nothing much also from the Biden administration. All the officials I try to reach are in radio silence right now. But I think it's pretty clear to everybody what's going on. There's what seems to be quite a significant airstrike in Iran near Isfahan, and you know, the air defense systems were activated. And I think it's fair to say that I cannot think of any other country right now other than Israel that has any interest or motivation to conduct such a strike in Iran.
It's an important point. Look, as you were hearing Alex Marquardt just a little while ago telling us what he had been hearing from U.S. officials, which is that they had been getting something that seemed to be parameters from the Israelis about what may or may not be fair game if there were to be a counterattack. According to Alex's sources, that they were not going to go after nuclear facilities. We do know that Isfahan there is a nuclear facility there. And just in February, Iran said that it started to build a research center there. So we know that. There's also an army facility near Isfahan as well. Do you hear anything on the Israeli side about what they think would be within the parameters of a counterattack?
Yeah, this is from a senior defense correspondent at Channel 13 inside of Israel. Based on the reports from Iran, the U.S. is a limited and targeted attack on one Air Force base near Isfahan. Official Israel does not address the reports. Oh, great. I'm glad that it was limited and targeted, dude, as opposed to what, indiscriminately firebombing the entire
what
nation?
What the Israelis were trying to do is to conduct a strike that will be a retaliation on the one hand against a military target in Iran, but on the other hand will not be too big so that it would push Iran for an even bigger attack than they conducted last Saturday. And I think it's a very, it's a very complicated balancing act. I'm not sure the Israelis are calculating well enough Iranian intentions and the Iranian willingness to retaliate again for this Israeli strike. And I think the next...
Why are you saying Channel 13 isn't reliable? The Israeli chatter, the Israeli teenager I talked to earlier today said he relies on Channel 13 alongside Yosef Haddad after saying Haaretz is biased and bad and laughing about Ofer Kassif.
Maximalist response to any kind of Israeli activity in Iran, essentially. As you just
noted,
he
said 13. He said Channel 14.
It's a question of whether the Israelis made the right calculation. If that is, in fact, the case... Do you think that inside of Israel there would be some second guessing about the wisdom of a counterattack?
Well, I think that the, I don't know if to call it a hope or an assessment, but what I heard from Israeli officials in the last few days is that they think that the Iranians will retaliate, but...
This is so funny. Iran's going to go after Israel's nukes per the IRGC, bro. Chatter's got the IRGC in his back pocket.
It won't be a wider retaliation than the one they conducted last Saturday. And then, you know, both sides will call it a day. But again, it's all assumptions. Nobody knows what the Iranians are going to do. And we can only look at what they were saying publicly. And you just said it a minute ago. They said that their response will be stronger than the initial attack on Saturday. And if that's the case, we might find ourselves in this, you know, escalation after escalation after escalation that can lead us to a regional war.
Where does it end, Barak? I mean, where does the confidence come that after one retaliation and then another response that it might stop?
Until this moment, there has been no air attack from outside the borders of Isfahan or other parts of the country, and they have only made a failed and humiliating attempt to fly quadcopters, and the quadcopters have also been shot down. The news of the American media is not true. What is this? News sources have said that three explosions were heard near Army hunting base in the northwest of Isfahan. The defense is activated in response to an object that is likely to be a small bird. It is said that the Army radar is one of the possible targets, and the windows of several office buildings have been broken. Fars reports pictures in the front of the Shakati base.
Thank you for all of that. CNN's Paula Hancock is in Beirut for us now. Paula, you are hearing now from the Iranians. What are they saying?
Well, Abby, what we have heard is the Iranians pointing out that if there was some kind of an Israeli response, if it went after Iranian assets, then the president,
drone, probably, right? I assume they're saying small drone, not small bird. That would be funny.
A more dangerous response. Now, as far as Tehran was concerned, after the drone and the missile attacks of last weekend, almost as that attack was still ongoing on Israeli soil, we heard from Tehran that they said this has been concluded. So as far as they were concerned, at least as far as they said publicly, that was in response for the Israeli attack on the diplomatic compound in Syria, which they said they felt as if it were on their home soil, on Iranian soil. As they said, it was a diplomatic compound, and that was their response to that. They were very clear that they believed that that was the end of it, something which Alex reporting has shown as well, that the U.S. was hoping would be the case. But clearly we have heard from the Israeli side that that is not the end of it, that they would be responding at some point as well. But from the Iranian side, we have also heard just yesterday, local time on Thursday, from a Revolutionary Guards commander who's in charge.
Hasanabi, I thought you didn't cover breaking news. There's an exception. Genuinely curious. I hope that, you know what, every day we inch closer and closer to full-blown nuclear annihilation, and I welcome it when I get genuinely curious chatters like this, which is the new Just Curious. Bro, what the f- are you talking about? Don't you think that this is a little bit different? Don't you think that this is a little bit different than like a random shooting that has occurred? I don't know. Okay, fair. Oh, okay, fair, I guess. January 6th was breaking news, too.
The Israeli nuclear assets
I'm going
are, for
to
example,
kiss myself.
And that they
I
could
will.
Go
I'm going
after
to kiss
those
myself.
Assets. Now, of course, a lot of this...
Yeah. I'm not over here... Thank you. I'm not over here speculating on, like, whether or not a mass shooter is trans, okay? It's a little bit different looking at mainstream media coverage. And also... openly trying to parse through a shit ton of the misinformation. But like I said, like I have joked so many times over, nukes could be launching right now and chatters would still be like, Hasan, you're a fake socialist. I just wanted to let you know that my final message before we die, before we perish from this earth, is that you're a fake socialist and I hate you, and have fun in your nice Hollywood mansion surrounded by your loved ones, which is an own, I guess.
That city contains is a facility that converts uranium ore into yellow cake, and eventually that gets enriched and then becomes a nuclear weapon. So the why I think that could possibly be a target, going back to what General Mark said, is because Israel wants to show Iran that it has the capability to reach out and get to that facility. Now, we don't know if that specific facility was attacked. They could have just... attacked around a military target around it in there in some cases. But the message I believe Israel would be sending, or hypothetically, is that they can get to that facility. That's an important facility because it's the second step in how nuclear bombs are made. And if Israel can take that linchpin out, then the Iran nuclear program is some.
Like, notice how fast they've started talking about how valid this target is. They don't even know what the target is yet. We don't even know. They're like, we don't know what the target is, but if it is this, then it's such a good target to hit. I mean, my dick is hard thinking about how dope it was that Israel hit Iranian soil.
So, Major General, just as you were speaking, we are now hearing that there have been explosions near an army base there in Isfahan. What do we know about the military capabilities that are located in that area?
Well, they're likely air defense platforms. They have those kind of weapon systems protecting all of their nuclear facilities here. So again, Israel decides to attack, come due east across Iran, takes out air defense platforms that exist in there. And to General Marx's point, do they attack with a cruise missile? I likely think that they used manned aircraft in this kind of operation to ensure.
Yeah. The attack attributed to Israel and Iran. There is currently no Israeli confirmation. The response was planned in such a way that Iran could contain the attack, although even for the assassination of the Iranian general, the intelligence did not estimate that Iran would respond with a missile attack. This is actually interesting. This is honest. Exactly. Military correspondent for Khan News says this. As we found out, Israel was like, oopsie, we didn't think Iran would retaliate if we killed a bunch of their generals in a goddamn embassy compound, which they did. So now they're, you know, now they're bombing Iranian soil. And I suspect that the consideration is still the same. Will Iran respond? I mean, oops, we didn't think that when they said we are going to retaliate swiftly with the might, with all of our might or whatever. I didn't think that that was real. Now, having said that, it might not be. It might not be a real retaliation. Judging by how timid Iranian retaliation has been, how calculated Iranian retaliation has been consistently, while the world is showing that they are going to unconditionally defend Israel and offer political cover for Israel, whether it is doing a genocide or whether it is violating the sovereignty of other countries in the region, and only attack and respond politically when you retaliate, a lot of regional actors feel alone, that the rule-based international order is completely fraudulent, which everyone already knew. So this puts Iran in a weird predicament as well, because it has to demonstrate strength. It has to project some semblance of strength, considering that Israel has no interest in stopping. And also, why would they? Nobody's telling them to stop. Iran has allies? Not necessarily. Iran has strategic partnerships. I wouldn't say they're allies. I suppose that after the Iran's failed attack, Israel will do whatever they want because they are not scared anymore. Yeah, brother. See, this is exactly the kind of attitude that I really hope dumbass Israeli officials don't have. Okay? Like, I hope this attitude is only relegated to Kevin Lomaxda and not, like, the actual defense minister, Yoav Gallant. You know what I mean? Because if they're operating on this idiotic assessment, then, you know, well, that spells trouble. Thank God it's only Kevin so far that thinks that. I hope. Fars News Agency reports that three explosions were heard near a military base northwest of Isfahan. Fars adds that a radar site may have been targeted. روز جمعه 31 فروردین ما اینجا مقابل پایگاه هشتم شکاری اصفهان هستش. I do hope that it's just literally nothing. Like, this is just like a silly billy, very 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 minor, no damage had, just like, oh, we have the capacity to strike you but we won't type shit. And then Iran's like, yeah, look how humiliated Israel is because they didn't actually hit anything. And the Western media is lying about the damage in order to cope with the reality that Israel is scared of Iran's might. And then we just end it there. Considering that they have not already retaliated, who knows? Who knows what it might be? But that, I feel like, is the best possible outcome here.
Control, because again, you've been showing the video yourself of the Iranian foreign minister threatening devastating responses should Israel attack Iran, which it certainly looks like they have done now.
Are there any more levers available to the United States to cool this down?
Well, I think President Biden has been doing his best, and you would think that he would have a lot of credibility because it was actually on Saturday. U.S. forces were defending Israel and shooting down actual missiles and drones that were headed to Israel. So that should buy a lot of goodwill. But clearly, the Israeli war cabinet was not listening to President Biden. And I assume they're now counting on the U.S. to protect Israel once again from any possible Iranian retaliation. So I would say that the U.S. certainly has some leverage, but it's obviously pretty limited.
Yeah, and up until this point, it has not been enough to change the actions of Israel. They are a sovereign country, but they rely very heavily, as you pointed out, on the United States for protection and also for weaponry. Max, stand by for us. I want to go to Spider Marks. He's standing by, reiterating the news here for folks who are tuning in right now. Three explosions have been heard near an army base inside of Iran, near the city called Isfahan. That is a very large city, the third largest in Iran. It's one where we know there is a nuclear base, but there is also a military base as well. Spider Marks, tell us more about what the military capabilities are in that area. And if there was something targeted there, what could it be?
Clearly, you're going to find a military capability, primarily air defense, in the vicinity of these enrichment facilities. So not surprising at all. And also, when you go back to the nuclear deal that was signed a number of years ago that the United States
it's
then...
It's so funny when people find out when I joke about, like, oh, we're bringing on General Spider, like, they don't realize that I'm actually making a joke about a real person that CNN brings on all the time.
The enrichment. And then transport or move that enrichment to a military facility. In
He's not
words,
the only
right
one. There's a bunch of generals with, like, psychopathic names like
with
that.
With very short movement requirements, distribution requirements, that might be difficult to detect. So it's not surprising at all. And so going after an enrichment facility
Mad
like
Dog
that,
Mattis.
Ideally, we certainly don't know what took place. But there will be a requirement to do some very thorough...
Generals love getting, like, weird ass names, bro. They literally get, like, they get funny ass names off of, like, how badly they did war crimes.
Iranian nuclear progress, the development of this capability, there has to be an assessment of what they accomplished. If it was simply to describe a capability that the Iranians have, it's no mystery to the world that the Iranians can conduct military operations along multiple lines of effort simultaneously. We see that right now. Hezbollah, Hamas, efforts elsewhere in the region, and then conducting this strike into Iran. I mean, this is quite amazing, not surprising entirely. The Israelis have this incredibly capable military force. So if they're not sending a message, they're trying to achieve a result.
See, okay, there you go. Iranian officials and allies are claiming that all explosions heard tonight are due to interceptions and that no explosions have occurred on the ground. Dude, regardless of how limited this strike was, it's still insane, okay? The fact that it happened at all is a direct shot, not at Israel, not at Iran, is a direct shot at America, okay? Biden's out here being like, please keep doing the genocide in Rafah. We were lying. We were wrong, okay? We were lying and we were wrong when we said you can't do the Rafah genocide. Just keep genociding the Palestinians. Just don't strike Iran. And then, like, the next hour, they're like, yeah, oh, I'm sorry. Did you say strike Iranian soil directly? Because I think we got the wrong... It cut out a little bit in the conversation that we were having. And I think you meant strike Iran. No, the IRGC did not say they're going to target Israeli nuclear sites in response. The IRGC talked about the potential for striking Israeli nuclear targets earlier before the strike happened. I think that's what you're confusing this with. Unless there's something new happening. I can't believe Iran is playing the nothing happened card. I mean, it doesn't seem to be that severe considering that people did hear explosions. There are Iranian chatters and shit. But I haven't seen a single piece of footage, not one, from the actual explosion. That is a little bit unique. And the only thing that you guys have sent me so far have been explosions from other places.
For over the past hour, this is a very visible strike. And now we have this confirmation that this was indeed Israel that is attacking Iran. So major questions now, where we go from here. We have to get a much better sense. Indeed, Israel and the U.S. have to have a much better sense of what was struck, what the damage was done, in order to be able to try to predict how Iran might respond. But we have gotten some very serious words from a whole range of Iranian officials over the course of the past few days, the latest of whom was this Iranian foreign minister in New York with our colleague Aaron Burnett tonight, warning that if Israel were to attack Iran, that they would strike back hard, that they would expand their range of targets beyond what just military, like last weekend, to include civilian, financial, and others, and that they could do so immediately. One thing to note from the foreign minister's interview, he said that they would not be going after U.S. targets unless the U.S. were somehow directly involved. I was told very firmly by a U.S. official not too long ago that the U.S. certainly did not give the green light to this Israeli operation. What we have heard all week long from senior administration.
What are you doing, bro? What is BRICS info? What is BRICS info? What is this? What is this? What is this? What are you doing? Bro, just send me Hinkledink as a source. Hey, up next on BRICS News, dude. This is good stuff. This is a educational moment for chatters to understand, like, a little bit more media literacy. Now, some of these accounts will get shit right sometimes, okay? That doesn't mean you should trust them. because they do not have a reliable way of verifying information. It's no different to me than sending me like the octopus that found, picked the right presidential candidate 8 years in a row. It's literally no different than that octopus, okay? I don't know how many picks that octopus made. Why am I watching local news programming right now? It's crazy. Do not insult him. I'm sorry. But that's what it is. It's the same energy. This is the guy who tweets from that account. Well, I take back everything I said. It does seem unironically like Bricks Info is pretty reliable. Yeah, I trust Matt with my life, dog. Thank you for understanding changing opinions. Bro, check OSINT Brad DEFCON USA is a reliable source. Yeah.
Of course, they could have been other military units that the Israelis thought was high value targets.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but if you want to send me reliable information, send it from the war perverts, not OSINT accounts, but dudes that work for like the FDD. Okay. I hate to admit this, but they are probably going to be the only source of reliable information in moments like this. Yeah, the Foundation for Defending Democracy. Yes, you heard me. Okay. Think tank foreign policy Andes are still going to be, and even they are unreliable in real time, but at least they are a little bit more reliable than OSINT guys who are looking at those guys and reposting their posts anyway. And also some Telegram shit. Like, BNO News is not great either, but this is at least like something that I've seen a lot. Phytux is a little bit more reliable, I guess. And that's where BNO News is getting their information from. But yeah, there's been no airstrike in Isfahan or other parts of the country. They only made a failed and humiliating attempt to fly quadcopters and they were all shot down. God, I hate Marco Rubio.
One of the big questions, of course, is also, what is Israel's long-term strategy? Is it seeking to prevent a nuclear weapon?
It seems, for people who are saying, like, should I be worried? We don't know yet. We don't know what Iran will do in retaliation, but it does feel like the Iranian statements that have come out thus far have been very restrained, considering the minimal impact that this attack had. It still is a violation, but I guess they don't consider this to be as severe of a violation as the red lines that they said they would have. Fars News Agency is good, obviously. This morning, some local sources reported this was... Wait, oh, this is... We covered this already, yeah. Some local sources reported the sound similar to an explosion was heard in the west of Tabriz City. Investigated by Fars reporters show that there was no explosion in Tabriz and the air defense fired upon seeing a suspicious object. Tabriz air defense is located in the area of Wadi Rahmat in the north of the city. This defense overlooks the city of Tabriz and is located at a distance about 2 to 3 kilometers from Tabriz refinery and petrochemical. Currently, Tabriz is in complete peace. Air raid sirens activated in northern Israel. Yeah, I mean, that's probably like Lebanese pause shots. It's different. I mean, I don't know. I don't know if this is, I don't know if it's because we're hyper-focusing on it now. But something to remember is that given the fact that we do not know. Yeah, there you go. Iranian state TV is reporting that several small drones were shot down in the airspace of Isfahan province. So here's the thing. Given the fact that America said, don't strike Iran, please, we'll let you do the genocide in Gaza, just don't strike Iran, and then Israel still struck Iran, albeit with a tiny, with a minuscule attack, with an anemic attack, it still opens up the opportunity. It still potentially opens up the opportunity for Iran to retaliate. Like, there's no guarantee they're not going to retaliate in this circumstance. So the fact that Israel was able to say "fuck you" and push away American calls for restraint is again another "fuck you" to the United States of America. A U.S. official confirms to me that Israel had carried out a strike against Iran. Both the official and another senior U.S. official say Israel indicated they would not attack nuclear targets. U.S. didn't greenlight this attack, the second official told me. Just another you, dude, because there's no guarantee Iran doesn't retaliate. It seems like they won't, but I'm saying you don't know that before you do this attack. And Israel still did the attack. I said, very cool that Israel gets to gamble on the Iranian response hours after Biden told them they could invade Rafah as a treat if they promise not to strike Iran. I'm sure we'll hear about how privately mad he is. Iran ground commercial aircraft across a wide area as the state-run media report air systems firing and the sound of explosions near the city of Isfahan. James Clapper weighed in on CNN. Predicts that Iran may strike back more strongly against Israel than its failed attack last week. I don't know. If that was going to happen, it would have happened already, I think. I mean, I don't know. Maybe. That is the gamble when you strike Iranian soil. But yeah, here, Itamar Ben-Gvir calling to dismantle the war cabinet yesterday due to their inaction. Pressure was clearly mounting on the coalition internally, too, in Gaza. Pictures of thousands bathing at the beach in the north. Hezbollah saw that the conception cabinet was not responding to the attack of hundreds of missiles from Iran into Israeli territory, so it raised its head and took an aggressive step against us that today causes wounded fighters. It's time to dismantle the conception cabinet. Is he mean war cabinet? Stop the policy of inclusion and proportionality and show our enemies that the landlord has gone mad. What? The landlord? Does he think that he owns the land all around, like all the way to Israel? Like, what's happened? I mean, all the way to Iran? Or is that just a translation mistake? Just what he calls a war cabinet? Okay. As long as the current policy of the conception cabinet continues, unfortunately, absolute victory is getting further and further away. Bro, who's he talking to? Like, sure, there's a lot of further right-wing motherfuckers out there than Benjamin Netanyahu. But it's wild that he's just always getting like 1K likes on tweets like this. It's like, bro, you ain't got the juice. You know what I mean? What is this? God, dude, get on Ozempic. Shut up. Make something of yourself. You know what I mean? Jesus Christ. Go work out, dumbass. Maybe you'll be less hateful, you know? He's like, bro, I swear to God, I'm going to disband the war cabinet, bro. I swear. If you don't let me do genocide right now, I'm going to do it. That didn't work on Meatball Ron. Bro, please stop sending me the same person saying I'm an Israhan and I didn't feel the explosion. Please, I got it, okay? I do care, however, about official Iranian news sources and what they say. I think that the reason why we care about this is because the reason why we care about this is not only because of the potential damage. The major reason why we care about this is because at the top of the hour, there's a 3-minute ad break. And if you no longer want to see those ads, all you need to do is subscribe for $5 or for free with a Twitch Prime by connecting your Amazon Prime account to your Twitch account, where you get one free Prime subscription a month. I doubt Iran responds. If it does, it could hit something sensitive in Israel, which in turn would lead Israel to conduct a more severe strike in an escalation cycle that ends in nuclear facilities hit in both countries. Neither side wants this. They just want to save face and establish deterrence. Exactly. I agree. Can we watch Iranian news? No, because none of you speak Farsi. I'm not going to sit here and try to understand what's going on by looking at Iranian news. Anyway, here's the 3-minute ad break. Now, inside Israel, the conception is used to refer to the way of thinking before October 7th. So the conception cabinet basically means pussy cabinet. It's so funny because Itamar Ben-Gvir is the biggest pussy of all time. Like, oh, God. IDF says the alarms in the north were false alarms. Do you guys understand? Here is what we have right now. A couple hours ago, there were reports coming out that there were explosions being heard in Syria, explosions being heard in Iraq, and explosions being heard inside of Iran. Immediately, the explosions being reported inside of Iran being in Isfahan made people think that it was at the nuclear site. However, it seems like, especially because of how limited the information was, okay, it seems like it wasn't that severe. However, it's still a big gamble. Why is it a big gamble? Because you don't know what Iran is going to do in retaliation. And it's especially a big gamble because the United States of America said, don't do it, okay? The nuclear site in Isfahan is reportedly okay, according to the Fars News agency. The nuclear facility in Isfahan is completely safe. The report of some foreign media about the incident in this facility is incorrect. So, like I said, even if Israel did not demonstrate their full power, their full striking capability here, it still doesn't matter. Because what if Iran did retaliate? That was always a very realistic outcome, considering that they said they would. So the fact that they still tried it to be like, here's our deterrence, either A, means that they just genuinely believe in Iranian restraint, which could be the case, but it's still a major gamble regardless because it's an unknown situation. The point I'm trying to make, I guess, is that it is an unknown escalation that will potentially be met with maybe even disproportionate response from a foreign adversary that America said don't f- with them. And they did this right after there were news reports coming out from the Biden team saying, one, we are vetoing the Palestinian statehood recognition for you, Israel. And two, if you want to invade Rafah, go ahead. As a treat, we will let you invade Rafah and continue your genocide. Just please don't strike Iran. The fact that Israel still turned around and struck Iran, albeit with a very anemic retaliation, is still fucked up. It's still a big fuck you. It almost feels like if Biden said, please, Israel, strike Iran, Israel would go, you know what? Fuck it. We're not going to do that. It's like opposite day over there. Whatever Biden says, the war cabinet does the exact opposite. It's happening. So maybe, hopefully, this means they won't invade motherfucking Rafah either, because Biden was like, you can invade Rafah. Just kidding. Of course, it's not going to happen. They're going to do both. Does not sound like nuclear sites were targeted. Military targets only. U.S. was notified in advance. Escalation was not the objective. Israel demonstrating its capability to reach inside of Iran at will. That is the step taken tonight to begin restoring deterrence. It's so funny that the FDD guy, Richard Goldberg, is saying this. Like, Iran doesn't know that Israel has the capability of reaching inside of Iran. Israel has reached inside of Iran before. The f*** are we talking about? Both through cyber attacks and also with direct targeting. What do you mean? And yeah, he's wrong. The United States was notified in advance, but the United States did not greenlight it. So there's that part too. Senior U.S. official tells Marquard TA, Alex Marquard, chief national security correspondent, that Israel informed the U.S., but we didn't endorse the response. Do you think the U.S. warned Iran through back channels? No, I don't think so, but I don't know, but I would doubt it. It's so funny that, like, this is, I think mathematically, the worst possible outcome for Biden. I can't comprehend it. It literally feels like more of a f*** you to Biden than it is to Iran. Sending like quadcopter drones or whatever the f*** they sent in that will easily be swatted away by any capable country's anti-aircraft defense systems is literally less of a f*** you to Iran than it is to Biden. Especially after Biden was like, don't do it. Don't do it, Jack. What is happening here? I mean, it could be multiple different reasons. Like our chatter brought up, that internal pressure from the war cabinet that demands a response that directly strikes Iran could be part of the reason. Bro, Ben-Gvir isn't seen as a pussy by his followers. He's literally seen as a strongman and a thug. This is how he presents himself. Just watch the video of him pulling out a gun on an Arab security guard from 2021. I remember this, dude. No, I refuse. You cannot say escalation was not the objective when Israel bombed an embassy and attacked, doing ironically the most minimal casualty count. And now the response is to fire back, hoping there's no escalation. No, I think it's stupid. I think Israel is that stupid to some degree. Or at least like they're communicating to Western media that they are that stupid. Because if they were genuinely worried that they would come across like dumbasses, there wouldn't be a New York Times article today, literally with the headline, Israel didn't think killing Iranian generals in an embassy compound would be worthy of a missile strike retaliation from Iran. So even if they genuinely are that stupid, or they're just presenting themselves as such, they are trying to communicate to the rest of the world that they are that dumb. I personally think they're not that dumb. I think that they do want to escalate the conflict, and they're going to keep prodding and pushing and pushing and pushing, trying to warrant some kind of response from, Iran. With the hopes that it will inevitably bring the United States of America into the conflict in a very meaningful way.
Really important reporting will continue to go to you as well. Important note that on February 26th of just this year, a nuclear watchdog report did suggest that Iran is enriching uranium to 60%. It's an important figure because weapons-grade uranium needs to be enriched to 90% to make a bomb. And just earlier on our own airwaves, the Iranian foreign minister was speaking to CNN. This is before the strikes, and said in case the Israeli regime embarks on adventurism again and takes action against the interests of Iran, the next response from us will be immediate, and at a maximum level, it will be decisive. That was the Iranian foreign minister speaking to CNN earlier this evening. I want to bring in CNN Pentagon correspondent Oren Lieberman. Oren, you reported in the region for a very long time. What is Israel's message now with this strike?
A large part of that depends on the damage on the ground, and we'll get a better sense of that in the coming hours and days. But if the initial reports coming out of Iran are correct, and it is fairly minor or relatively small damage, then the message from Israel is simply to point out that they have the capability to do this. It's not just Iran that can fire hundreds of miles and hit Israel. Israel has the capability to do that exact same thing right back to Iran. And Isfahan is an interesting choice there because of the nuclear facilities. At least in the initial reports, it doesn't seem like that's what Israel was going after in this strike, but it's a clear message to Iran that if this escalation continues and gets out of control, it is well within Israel's capabilities to hit Iran's nuclear facilities. That looks like the message being sent here. Of course, now the question, does Iran follow through on the promise made by the foreign minister and others to retaliate for this attack and fire back? Is Iran going to fire more ballistic missiles and drones at Israel? And what happens in that case? The U.S. position is clear. The U.S. will try to help intercept any launches as early as possible that are targeting Israel. It's the other countries and the other partners in the region that are the question mark here. They participated, for example, Jordan intercepting foreign objects in its airspace over its territory and participating in the interception of that Iranian attack several days ago. Do they do that again? Are they willing to take that step? Or now that they see that this is Israel's retaliation, do they step out of that? It's a much bigger task for the U.S. if they have to defend the airspace on their own. That's one of the key questions here. We haven't seen the Pentagon comment at this point. We haven't heard a public statement from military officials, but just like the White House, just like Israel, the Pentagon obviously watching the situation there very closely. Laura.
Oren, we've now seen both countries try to demonstrate their capability to reach one.
MAGA communists were right. Donald Trump, once again, based permanent first world genocidist, Maoist third worldist. He destroyed the Iran denuclearization agreement, hoping that Iran would reach nuclear proliferation immediately. And when Iran literally pussied out and was like, no, we're still going to follow the protocols because this is a big deal for us. Please don't sanction us. He still sanctioned them, even though the European counterparts were still investigating the nuclear facilities and saying that they were complying. Donald Trump, on the other hand, being the JD pawn advocate that he is, said, no, permanent first world genocide now. Iran deserves nukes. And said, no, we're going to put sanctions on Iran again, as a matter of fact, even though you're complying. Why? So that Iran could develop nukes and that we could have a nuclear holocaust. That is the reason why Donald Trump did this. He was a Maoist third worldist. I never understood this until this very moment. Turns out Donald Trump, Lisan Al-Gaib, said family atomics for Saudi Arabia. Now Joe Biden is giving family atomics to Saudi Arabia. Okay, family atomics for all, he said. Nukes for all, baby. So yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. It was always the case. The case was that Donald Trump is literally a Maoist third worldist. And the MAGA communists were correct.
Abilities and other capabilities, but they probably pose a very limited threat to the Israelis. The other thing to keep in mind, Laura, is that when it comes to the nuclear facilities in and around Isfahan, the one that's really important is the Natanz nuclear facility. And that is 120 kilometers or about 70 miles away from Isfahan. So if you strike the area around Isfahan, you are not going to be striking the city of Isfahan, that is, you're not going to be striking Natanz. But you are telling them, as we've talked about, you are telling everybody that you can reach this area and you can, in fact, eliminate that threat or at least attack that threat if you need to do so.
When he says it's well within their reach, he's framing it as it's well within their right because everyone knew Israel could hit Iran. But when you frame it in the sense of it's well within, it's almost automatic for Westerners to preempt with right. I mean, they have openly stated that. That part they openly stated as well. Dude, the guy literally was like, we don't even know what happened. We don't even know if it's a nuclear base, but if it is, it's fucking sick. Imagine how dope it is that Israel may have struck the nuclear facility. I mean, that would be sick. And it's like, dude, you don't even know what happened. Why are you defending it? What's wrong with you? Do you think Israel is trying to call Biden's bluff? Do they think he's bluffing about the extent of U.S. involvement? I don't know what Israel's doing as far as Biden's bluff. I do know, however, that Benjamin Netanyahu benefits from not Biden. He doesn't like Biden. He, even though Biden has been a rabid Zionist from the jump. Like, Biden is a more consistent ally to Israel than even Donald Trump is because Donald Trump is volatile. If you hurt his feelings, like, who knows what he might do? There's a level of instability with Donald Trump. But Donald Trump and Benjamin Netanyahu are the exact same type of corrupt fascist idiots that I think, like, he likes the prospect of Donald Trump being in power because he thinks he probably can manipulate Donald Trump way better than he can even manipulate Biden. But you don't even need to manipulate Biden. Like, Biden will do it anyway. Trump got a bit colder. No, he didn't, dude. Are you kidding me? Trump will be being like, kill the Iranian dogs now. Like, get the out of here. Y'all are crazy. Iranian media saying drone attack came from Kurdistan. What? Was carried out through parties located in the Kurdistan region of Iraq. Damn, bro, Turkey's about to pop in. Turkey's about to jump in, dude. Any day now, Recep Tayyip Erdogan is sending the sending the commandos to Israel. Trust. Biden is asleep right now. He will wake up mad as if Iran doesn't respond. I think it's all calculated by all parties. I mean, it doesn't seem like they will. Everything that the Iranian media has said has been very, very careful. Iran state media claims target in alleged Israel strike was not nuclear sites. Earlier today, the IRGC commander in charge of security and nuclear facilities said that Iran's nuclear policy can change if nuclear sites are hit, implying a move towards the production of nukes. Post hoc rationalization. What's the post hoc rationalization? Iran should just accept that Israel is USA-backed and they don't have much of a shot. Yeah, they should just sit back and take it, honestly. Everyone should sit back and take it. It's all up to Israel. No one else. Oh, chatter that said it was all planned. Yeah, no, I don't think it was all planned. I don't think Israel is operating within the bounds of reason here. But it doesn't seem like it was a big deal, so that's good.
The dominant position on both sides.
Bobby Ghosh, thank you so much. I want to reference and play right now what the Iranian foreign minister told CNN's Aaron Burnett just earlier tonight.
I don't know what the reason is for why they're showing this kind of stuff and not necessarily showing that the Iranian media is consistently saying, at least with the limited amount of information we have from Iranian media, they keep repeating over and over again that it's not that big of an attack, that it was like basically nothing. Yeah, we already showed this Hossein Dalirian. Until this moment, there's been no air attack from outside the borders of Isfahan, or other parts of the country, and they have only made a failed and humiliating attempt to fly quadcopters, and the quadcopters have also been shot down. Why is my brother calling me?
Bonds from us will be immediate and at a maximum level. It will be decisive.
Very daunting words. It will be immediate at a maximum level. It will be decisive. I want to bring in CNN Global Affairs analyst Kim Dozier. Kim, the foreign minister, you've heard the words he's spoken, that it would be immediate. How does the United States now go about managing what has obviously now been elevated to the next level?
Well, one of the scary things that we've been talking about this evening is the fact that the Iranians are closing the airspace and closing all those different airports because they could be doing that to keep civilian aircraft safe, or they could be doing that to prepare for immediate retaliation.
Well, Israel spent 2 days after Iran saying that it was nothing and mocking it and then retaliated. I'm not sure the Iranian media response right now means they won't retaliate. No, Eve Shartlow's poop sock. It does. Because Iran also said that if you actually struck us and violated our red lines, we would retaliate immediately. So, and Iran has been the more restrained party in this process, literally from the start. Restrained, depending on where you are in the region, and depending on what you believe, okay, maybe to a fault.
The Israelis hit, actually, their targets. The why behind the target still remains. Was it to get close to the nuclear facilities? Was it to destroy aircraft or missiles that were possibly launched from that location on the attack? Was it, again, to go after air defense systems that they want to take out now that will help them in the future? So again,
I think
it just shows
it
that from
like
a deterrence perspective, it's back on the ball's back on the side of Israel. They have
I think
much
if
more
Iran
military.
Was going to retaliate, and if they thought that this was like a severe enough attack, they would have already retaliated. We'd be covering the Iranian retaliation right now.
Reporting talks about that the range of targets never specified in precise terms, but nuclear and civilian locations were not in the category of the types of information they were going to try to carry out. When you hear this, Max, and see the potential for escalation, we do know that the United States, according to our reporting, had some notice that it was coming in the days. Does that have an impact on the United States's need to involve themselves, or are we still in a watchful position?
They took 2 weeks to retaliate last time. Yeah, it doesn't matter. This time, before the retaliation last time, they literally urged the international community to take action against Israel and only retaliated after they didn't. And also, this time they literally said, if Israel attacks our nuclear facilities, like, we will explore the nuclear option. And if Israel attacks us on Iranian soil, we will immediately respond with massive force. So I think that I don't think that they are. If Iran was going to retaliate, the council will be meeting also. There have been no emergency meetings of Iran's Supreme National Security Council, according to the Tasnim news agency. Why aren't the Israeli officials claiming it? No, they did, I think. Also, I actually don't know. Didn't they? I thought they did. Bro, whatever. America already confirmed it. Who gives a shit if Israel confirms it or not? You know what I mean? Like, America already confirmed it. That's it. That's all you need, bro. What do you mean Israel didn't confirm it? When does America even confirm Israeli actions? Sometimes Israel will be like, yeah, we did that shit. And America will be like, did they? So I'm sorry. But if America is confirming that Israel struck a target, I'm going to go with Israel definitely struck a target. Like, literally, Kirby, the State Department official, was fielding questions as Israel was like, yeah, we struck those World Central Kitchen guys. Sorry. My bad. We're looking into it. And they were asking Kirby about it. And that was like, did they? And if they did, maybe it was good. Did you think about that? Maybe they were Hamas. It's like, bitch, you don't know. What do you mean? So, yeah, we are definitely, depending on who you're talking about, the State Department, depending on which spokesperson we're talking about, like, we're sometimes to the right of Israel on issues. It's insane. Which is, of course, precisely the reason why I think it was Matt Miller that got yelled at by the IDF. But yes, tonight, the Nothing Ever Happensers have won once again. Although, like I said, things are happening all the time. And the Nothing Ever Happensers are delusional and stupid for saying nothing ever happens only because they live in America and these AmeriFat pieces of only think something happens when their goddamn gasoline is $5 extra per gallon. Okay? When they start paying European prices for gas, they're like, oh, something is happening. You stupid diabetic piece of shit out here with the nothing ever happens nonsense. 40,000 motherfuckers dead and motherfuckers still in the chat, including Weeby, going, nothing ever happens. Anyway, I'm glad that nothing ever happens today. But yeah, it's just the only people that get away with saying shit like that are people that just don't live in the region where things are happening all the time. I'll fall into that trap. I know. It's just like, whatever. I'm doing 9 hours of 30 minutes of full-blown news. Is annoying. What do you think Iran's response will be? I don't think, I don't know. I'm not going to make a prediction on this. But judging by what they've done so far, they've been restrained. And like I said, depending on where you are living, you might even say too restrained, restrained to a fault even. So I think it's good that they're restrained, obviously, and we shall see what happens. But it is, once again, another very obvious Israel told to America moment.